So I started noticing, like, once my phone started to glitch in a weird way, which I would have paid no attention to, then I got a PayPal email to an email address that I definitely don't use with PayPal, stating that I have, like, money on PayPal account. I got a Squarespace notification that my account has been accessed in China. There was someone using like an anonymous, like half anonymous name, and saying that there was like a that I had been doxxed. So basically, someone had published my information online and sending a link. And then I was like, phishing or not, and made that like a Twitter thing. And then the guy got really sad, and I felt sad because I had made him sad. Yeah. But I never clicked the link though.
That was actually us.
Yes. Yes. So you played my empathy.
Yes, we did.
I really love the fact that like you use things like Pastebin, which is like a thing that I would recognize. So
yeah, the Squarespace thing was also us.
Yeah,
we were trying to get those two, trying to get access to your Gmail by those two.
Is it like, because I checked the Squarespace was squarespace.fi, and I started to think like,
Yeah, it was actually squarepace.fi.
Squarepace.
Yeah.
That I didn't notice. Yeah. In general, because so much of my life was online and I realized that I have like a gazillion unused accounts, is it easier to target someone like that or someone who you can like, who doesn't have much presence online?
In general, I would say that it's easier to, if you have a big digital fingerprint online, then it's easier to target you because of course you can maybe gain access to an older MySpace account or something like that and use that for some like further leverage to move forward with the attack.
So after I would have clicked on a link, it would have led me to like a Google page that looks exactly like a Google page.
Yeah.
Is there anything I could have done at that point to kind of protect me?
Well, yeah, basically we registered like a generic domain and we stole the look and feel from actual Google login. So if you're really strict on, for example, reading the or seeing what the URL is and who has registered, for example, the HTTPS certificate that is used on the page, then you can spot that it's not the correct one, but it requires a certain level of yes, exactly.
And what if I had typed my password? What happens then?
Then we would have just recorded your password and it would have forwarded you to the actual login page.
How, like, what would have happened when you had the password? How would you have masked your access from me so that I wouldn't notice that you have access?
In the case of Gmail, for example, there are some further security controls that we would need to have figured out. For example, it sometimes notices when you're looking in for unusual IP addresses and so on.
Yeah, because I've gotten those notifications.
Yeah. But the easy way of protecting against this is to use the two-factor authentication that Gmail is offering or Google is offering. So then you also would need to use the mobile application for...
So guess what? I have that.
Ah, okay, so that...
So the end goal wasn't only to get into my email, right?
For an attacker, your network would be valuable. So gaining access for example, your email or LinkedIn account or something like that would be good. So we could leverage your persona in attacking other businesses. Attacker would, for example, search for like a discussion you had with like a high value.
Something
like that. And then we would just, because we would be able to hijack that discussion as you, and then, for example, send some kind of crafted malware payload or something like that to the recipient, so and gain access to his or her organization.
How big a role do human errors play in like attacks like these?
Well, I don't know if it's an error because, of course, emails are designed to be opened and read and so on. So that's the typical way in. But of course, it should be there should be other controls in place to protect against this like first line of attack.
So I definitely taped all of the cameras and audio tracks of my like phones and emails because I didn't know what kind of like. What is like the level of smartness one should have when facing situations like these? Going forward, should I still keep everything taped?
Well, I think that is not strictly speaking necessary. I think that they're using just like the good controls that the services you use are in place. For example, the two-factor authentication thing, that's an excellent way of protecting against these phishing attacks.
Thank you for watching, and remember to like, share, and subscribe. And if you don't feel like liking, sharing, and subscribing, remember, you can also hack us. We have a bug bounty, and if you are able to break into our services, we will pay you money. Good luck, and I'll see you online.